Just click the Sunday Worship Aid link on the front page of our parish website, oldstmarys.com. Presiding and preaching at this liturgy is Father Johnson. Our gathering song is number 886, The Summons, number 886.
Will you come and follow me if I but call your name? Will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name be known? Will you let my life be grown?
Let us be gathered in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with each one of you.
And with your spirit.
Just to set some minds at ease, I'm smelling some smoke, and that's coming in from a fire that's several blocks away, so our air conditioning unit is bringing some smoky air in. So hopefully all is going well over there. The fire department is on the scene. My brothers and sisters, as we begin our worship this evening, let us ready ourselves to hear God's word.
Lord Jesus, you are the word who challenges us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the prophet who speaks to us today. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you help us to hear your call and heed your word. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory.
Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy, grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord God opens my ear that I may hear, and I have not rebelled, have not turned back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard. My face I did not shield from buffets and spitting. The Lord God is my help, therefore I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame. He is near who upholds my right. If anyone wishes to oppose me, let us appear together. Who disputes my right? Let that man confront me. See, the Lord God is my help. Who will prove me wrong? The word of the Lord.
Before the Lord in the land of the surround me, the snares of death. The anguish of the grave has found me. Anguish and sorrow I found. I called on the name of the Lord. Deliver my soul, O Lord. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. How gracious is the Lord and just! Our God has compassion. The Lord protects the simple. I was brought low and he saved me. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. He has kept my soul from death, my eyes from tears and my feet from stumbling. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living.
A reading from the letter of St. James. What good is it, my brothers and sisters, if someone says he has faith but does not have works? Can that faith save him? If a brother or sister has nothing to wear and has no food for the day, and one of you says to them, go in peace, keep warm, and eat well, but you do not give them the necessities of the body, what good is it? So also faith of itself, if it does not have works, is dead. Indeed, someone might say, you have faith and I have works. Demonstrate your faith to me without works, and I will demonstrate my faith to you from my works. The word of the Lord.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus and his disciples set out for the villages of Caesarea Philippi. Along the way, Jesus asked his disciples, "Who do people say that I am?" They said in reply, "John the Baptist, others Elijah, or still one of the other prophets." And he asked them, But who do you say that I am?" Peter said to him in reply, "You are the Christ." Then Jesus warned them not to tell anyone about him. He began to teach them that the Son of Man must suffer greatly, be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, be killed, and rise on the third day. He spoke this openly. Then Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. At this, Jesus turned around and looked at his disciples, rebuked Peter, and said, "Get behind me, Satan. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do." Jesus summoned the crowd with his disciples and said to them, "Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake and that of the gospel will save it." The Gospel of the Lord. The event at Caesarea Philippi that we hear about in today's gospel lesson was a real turning point in Mark's gospel. To answer Jesus' question, "Who do you say that I am?" we hear that Peter boldly pronounces, "You are the Messiah, you are the Christ." Up to this point, Jesus' identity had been rather shrouded in questions and confusion. This man of sorrows with buffeted face and plucked beard was not the image that sprang to mind when Israel prayed for a deliverer. He wasn't the subject of songs of praise, but the object of jokes and of scorn. Yet, despite this humiliation, he had been endowed with the Spirit of God. And his message was not merely a verbal one, rhetoric and oratory. Rather, the example of his life spoke as loudly and as powerfully as his words. In today's second reading from that letter of St. James, we hear the writer advocate for a living and active faith, which, because it had become central to the believer's life, is expressed as made visible in ethical and just behavior. To wish a person well, we're told, and then to neglect their needs, well, that's like saying, "I believe," and then failing to act and to live accordingly. Rather, at the appearance of the Son of Man, judgment would be rendered not based on the intellectual perfect faith that a person might have, but on the basic acts of faith-filled love and kindness. Such an active and living faith leads to eternal life, whereas the faith that remains unexpressed in deeds remains fallow and lifeless. Upon hearing him preach, the ordinary people knew that Jesus was exceptional and in possession of an authority unlike anyone they'd ever heard before, but they were unsure of who he really was. His reputation spread throughout Galilee, but some wrongly perceived him to be some mysterious figure like Elijah, whom they thought would herald the coming of the Messiah. Others, who had believed that John the Baptist was the Messiah, thought, "Well, that's John, come back to life." And still others thought Jesus to be a prophet like Moses. The scribes and Pharisees and Herodians witnessed Jesus' works and heard his teaching and recognized in his rather radical ways a threat to their positions and their prestige as teachers. In fear and resentment, they rejected him and plotted against him. Jesus' own disciples were filled with ambivalence toward Jesus, hoping for a political Messiah and confused by the image conveyed to people, that Jesus conveys to people. And even Jesus' relatives didn't perceive his true purpose or understand his method. They thought he was mad, and they wanted to protect him from himself, from the authorities. But at Caesarea Philippi, the confusion as to Jesus' identity was brought to a climax by the confession of Peter that we hear tonight. You are the Christ. You are the Messiah. However, Jesus brought his messianic, his messiahship, to an unpopular and difficult and unattractive time. Instead of being a political leader and a powerful king like King David was, and those who followed after King David, Jesus in turns is this shocking, almost pitiable figure, much like the 6th century servant in the writings of the prophet Isaiah, rejected, scorned, laughed at, made fun of, beaten. To all who thought and who judged by human standards, Jesus' ideas were iconoclastic. Closely linked to the revelation of Jesus as Messiah and as one who would suffer is the invitation to discipleship, to follow this suffering servant. By summoning the crowds, Jesus made it clear that all those who followed him would have a share in the cross and the suffering. And it wasn't reserved just to the 12 apostles, the closest disciples of Jesus, but it was a challenge and invitation extended to all believers. Well, today's three scripture readings share a common theme, the theme of discipleship. And they call each of us to a life dedicated to the belief that the alleviation of suffering, especially innocent suffering, is a sacred duty, to the belief that it's vital that we walk the walk as well as talk the talk, and to the belief that these and the often countercultural qualities of Christian living are all a part of the believers, part of our daily answer to Jesus' question and Jesus' invitation to follow him. The way we live our lives reflects how we have personally answered Jesus' question. Who do you say that I am? Let us renew our profession of faith, and this evening let us do so using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who is conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Inspired by the Word of God, we now turn to God, and in faith we offer these prayers.
That Pope Francis and all bishops, priests, and deacons will lead all into a deeper relationship with Jesus Christ, who came to guide us in the way of holiness, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May families be strengthened in bonds of love and charity through the prayer and example of grandparents, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We remember with sorrow the tragic events of September 11th, 2001. For all who died that day, for those who lost loved ones, for those who courageously responded to provide aid and comfort, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have suffered the devastation of earthquake, storm, and flood. Keep safe all who come to assist them, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Have mercy on refugees who have been torn from their homes to seek new lands. Relieve those who feel they have no place in the world and give them new hope, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick will know relief from their pain, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all those who have died will inherit the joys of everlasting life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of Teresia and Julie Josen, and for all the intentions we hold in silence, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Hear our prayer, God of tender mercy. Inspire us to work for justice for the poor and peace throughout the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As always, we thank you for your financial support of the ministries here at Old St. Mary's. Those of us, you who are joining us from home may make a contribution by either mailing it to the parish office, or you may go online to set up an automatic or an electronic giving. And as always, we thank you for your generosity.
The song during the preparation of the gifts is number 766, These Alone Are Enough, number 766.
Take my heart, O Lord, take my hopes and dreams. Take my mind with all its plans and schemes. Give me nothing more than your love and grace. These alone, O God, are enough. Thoughts, O Lord, and my memory. Take my tears, my joys, my liberty. Give me nothing more than your love and grace. These alone, O God, are enough for me. Give me nothing more than your love.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that our offering may be acceptable to God the Almighty. Look with favor on our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these, our offerings, that what each has offered in honor of your name may serve the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed men and women in your own image and set humanity over all the world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all that you have made and forever to praise you in your mighty works through Jesus Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we implore you by that same Spirit to graciously make holy these gifts that we have brought to you, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this Eucharist. For on the night he was betrayed, he took bread and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when they had finished supper, Jesus took the cup. Once again, he gave you thanks. And giving it to his disciples, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his coming again, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look upon the offering of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose will you wish to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Paul and all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, and all the people that you have gained as your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful God, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. In our voices we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant us peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we might be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look then not upon our sins, but upon the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with those around us some sign of the peace of Christ. Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy and blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The song during communion is number 1050, Broken for the Broken, number 1050.
Given for us all, broken for the broken, shed. proclaim your death, O Lord, not sacrifice and sign. For the hungry ones, for the thirsty ones, for the lonely ones you call us to serve, to be Christ for each other. Blessed feast of God's creation, given for us all. Broken for the broken, shared for humankind. We proclaim your death, O Lord, God's sacrifice and sign. For the ones abused, for the ones confused, for the ones refused, you call us to love, to be Christ for each other, broken for the world. Broken for the broken, poured out for the poor, blessed feast of God's creation, given for us all. Broken for the broken, shed for humankind. We proclaim your death, O Lord, God's sacrifice and sign.
Let us pray. May this heavenly gift, O Lord, take possession of our minds and hearts, so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Kindly be seated for some announcements. As always, we thank you for joining us for worship, both here in person and those who are joining us from home. A reminder that the Paulus Fathers, who have staffed Old St. Mary's since 1903, are in the midst of a Hope for the Future capital campaign. We thank all of those of you who have already made a donation, a pledge to this campaign. If you have not already received that material in the mail from Paulus Father Eric Andrews, please let Father Brad know that. Next weekend is our Just One Item collection, the third weekend of the month. When shopping this week, consider purchasing an extra item, tube of toothpaste, a deodorant, bar of soap, something like that. We'll contribute it to our friends at St. James, and they'll make very good use of it. When you come next weekend, you can just deposit it in the basket in the commons. All the children of the parish, age 10 and up, are invited to serve as altar servers, and there'll be a training for new and returning servers next weekend after the Saturday evening Mass and after the 11 o'clock Sunday Mass. There's more information in the bulletin about that, and we encourage all the youth of the parish to consider that ministry. Reminder that in accord with the Archdiocese and guidance and that of the public health officials, all those 2 years old and elder, vaccinated or not vaccinated, are asked to wear a mask indoors whenever you're at Mass or in the church. Reminder that we continue to stream our Masses at oldstmarys.com, and they're also recorded and uploaded to YouTube. Please pick up a copy of the parish bulletin, which is available on the tables in the Commons. Please take that with you. There's more information about these announcements. Now I'd like to call parishioner, Niall McShane. He'd like to come forward and say a few words.
Faith without works is dead. As Father PJ explained in his homily, we disciples of Christ have a responsibility to help alleviate suffering in this world. This is the essence of the principle of solidarity enshrined in Catholic social teaching. As a Catholic who is trying to live out this call to discipleship, what can you do? The magnitude 7.2 earthquake that hit Haiti on August the 14th was quickly followed by Hurricane Grace on August the 16th. And there were continued aftershocks in the range of 4 to 5 magnitude for many days that continued to disrupt relief and recovery efforts. According to Wikipedia, at least 2,248 people were confirmed dead, over 12,000 injured in the deadliest natural disaster of 2021. At least 136,800 buildings were damaged or destroyed. The loss of life has been limited by the fact that the quake struck an area away from the capital of Port-au-Prince, unlike the 2010 earthquake. What can you and I do to help in this situation? We can give aid to the Red Cross, Oxfam, and other major international relief agencies. But as we know from the aftermath of the earthquake in 2010, much of that relief does not actually get to those most affected by the disaster. And these agencies are ill-equipped to handle the conditions on the ground in Haiti, which include a barely functioning civil administration and widespread gang activity, especially in and around the capital, Port-au-Prince, where most of the aid has to flow through. Another way to help is to work with agencies that are already on the ground in Haiti and that are working directly with the people who are most affected. 10 years ago, I traveled to Haiti with a group that works with a coffee growers association in the village of Baradere, which is very close to the epicenter of this year's earthquake. We were selling the coffee in the parish that I attended at that time, and we wanted to meet the growers to see for ourselves how our efforts were helping them to build sustainable lives for themselves and their families. We visited the cities of Lekai, as well as the villages of Baradere and Fontortou, all of which suffered heavy damage in the earthquake. We attended a meeting of the coffee growers, many of whom traveled miles over dirt roads to attend, and we heard stirring stories of how the association had helped them build a life, educate their children, pay for medical care, and find hope in a world that offered little. Today, the village of Baradere is mostly destroyed. Many of the people that I met 10 years ago are homeless. Please join me in providing direct assistance to these people by purchasing their coffee through the website at justhaiti.org, where you can buy individual bags of coffee or sign up for a subscription that will deliver 2 bags of coffee per month at a discounted rate. Just Haiti pays the farmers the fair trade price for their raw coffee, but it goes further than that. Because Just Haiti works on a direct trade model, when the coffee is roasted and sold in the United States, all of the profits from those sales are returned to the coffee growers as well. Started in Baradere over 10 years ago, this model has been replicated in other villages in the region and has brought sustainability to other communities and continues to expand and impact the lives of more ordinary Haitians. If you don't drink coffee, you can also donate at the same website. And I have some leaflets and other materials. I'll be outside in the Commons after Mass. Thank you.
Thank you, Niall. And Niall will be at the table in the Commons. I'd be happy to share some information, more information with you, and also to answer your questions. Today is National Grandparents Day. So I'd like to invite all the grandparents among us to please stand. If you don't mind revealing the fact that you're a grandparent, and I don't think you are, let us extend a hand toward them as we offer a blessing. God of the ages, from generation to generation, you have been our refuge and our strength. We give thanks for grandparents and we pray for them. We give thanks that they connect us with our heritage and our roots. We give thanks for the ways in which they inspire and enlighten us. We give thanks for their example of faith, for their witness of their lives, for the constancy of their love, for the support of their prayers. We ask you to bless all grandparents and keep them in your care. Bless them with peace, health, and healing. And grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Happy Grandparents' Day.
The Lord be with you.
May the blessing of God come upon you and remain with you always, the blessing of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has ended. Let us go forth in faith and action.
Thanks be to God. The recessional song is number 702, Praise to You, O Christ, our Savior, number 702.
Only law is love. You are the way made
flesh who lives among us. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Praise to you, O Christ, our Savior, Word of the Father, calling us to life, Son of God, who leads us to freedom.